there. You're watching Down Under Derby TV.
Figuring out some technical difficulties right now, guys. Getting Sasha online.
Hello. There we go. Okay, cool. Hi, guys.
Doing a little bit of microphone play-by-play, getting everything ready before we start today.
So this weekend, we've had our special guest all the way from Argentina, the ThunderQuads. They are in the black and the yellow, and they have lightning bolts on their uniforms. I am very excited and very honored to have them as our guests. If you are watching, you can talk to us by live tweeting using the hashtag MRDADU. There's a lot of D's in that hashtag.
All the D, all the time. Sasha's got her lightning bolts ready to go.
I do. I cut out some glittery lightning bolts and I stuck them to skewers so that I could wave them and say, go ThunderQuads! Also, I'm a huge fan of Capital Carnage, not going to lie. Those pink uniforms get me every time.
All about the pink uniform.
People always tell me, as a commentator, you've got to be impartial. And I'm like, I'm a huge fan of both teams.
No impartialness from us. We are not wearing stripes today.
I am in yellow and black.
I am representing the Crash game from last year. Where we raised funds for Nepal and had a great time playing with my male derby counterparts. Always fun to get a little action on the men's teams.
The ThunderQuads are already ready on the track. We have Chispa jamming for the ThunderQuads. And Boyd jamming for Capital Carnage. All the skaters are shaking hands and hugging and we're all friends here in men's derby. We're just so honored for the opportunity to be able to play such an esteemed team as the ThunderQuads, who are number 13 in the world. They are ranked, playing against the unranked but newly affiliated with MRDA team, Capital Carnage.
Sasha taking a selfie. Selfie queen of the commentator's desk this
and
weekend.
And they're off. Boy to the outside. Shispa to the inside. And I would like to apologize in advance for any mispronunciations. Let me know what I'm doing and I'll fix it. Boyd being recycled by those yellow blockers. Number four is a personal favorite of mine. He's absolutely deadly. And ThunderQuads take lead.
Boyd and his fabulous hair are getting caught up by two of the ThunderQuads at the front of the pack, trying valiantly to just find his way and fight his way through. Chispa getting 5 points on the board for the ThunderQuads.
And both pivots from both teams just got released from the box, rejoining the pack.
Blocker advantage right now for Carnage. Hopefully they can help out Astro Boyd and get him through. Power jam for ThunderQuads, giving them the full advantage in this first jam of the day of the game for our second game of the day. Big thank you to Even Steven, who brought me a coffee from the last round. Much appreciated. I've now had three. I think I need to cut myself off. Just by making quick work of that pack.
And he's through again on the outside line. 5 more points. He already is on a 25-point jam for the first jam of the game. Boyd finally makes it through with a star stash, and Chispa calls it. Did he call it or natural end?
Natural end.
Natural end. We have David Deckham here on the line with number 1212, Cruise. Oh, he usually just cruises on through.
Oh, you're so punny.
That's so good. I've been waiting all weekend to do that one.
Little bit of a pivot line start for the teams, giving our jammers a bit of a run up, hitting that pack with some speed.
And the ThunderQuads take lead. Oh, no, they do not. It is a back block to Cruz. I believe lead may still be available if it was not called before the back block, which means David Deckham still has 30 seconds to get through before Cruz is back on the track. Nice work, David Deckham. David Deckham is not lead. But he got through on his initial, and he's on his first scoring pass. He jumps the apex, but stacks it a little bit and recycles himself behind the ThunderQuads. Cruz is sneaking back onto the track. Carnage look ready for him. But he cruises on through, completing his initial pass. He is also not lead.
This will be a two-minute jam.
Thuganaut being sent to the box for a hit on Cruz.
David Deckham getting caught up in that front pack.
And Cruz is through with 5 points on that single foot inside line skate through. David Deckham skipping through, leaving a trail of fallen skaters behind him. But Cruz has got his number, trying some jammer on jammer action. There is no lead. They're just racing each other around. David Deckham trying to juke and trick the ThunderQuads pack, but they catch him. Cruz picks up 4 points. End of jam.
Points finally on the board for Carnage in that second jam. 9-38 on the track. We have number 2528.
We have, Raichu. I love Raichu because Raichu is an electric Pokemon.
Ah, that's amazing. Learning all sorts of things over here.
Bobby Smack also jamming for Carnage. But Raichu takes lead for the ThunderQuads.
Bobby wearing his Bob and Weaver pants.
Bobby is through on his initial. Raichu sees him. The ThunderQuads speed up the pack and run away from the jammers. Copter is right out there in front, ready. Raichu calls it off. Here we go on the jam line for the ThunderQuads. We have yellow 08 PBay. PBay has been the most outstanding jammer this weekend and always. He is up against Boyd from Carnage. PBay is, I believe, one of the best jammers, male jammers in the world.
Watching him yesterday and just leaping over other players.
Did you see him at the World Cup?
No, I didn't watch any of the Argentina games. I also am really bad at the time conversion and always slept through them.
PBay is through. PBay takes lead. He is so agile. He is so swift. He zigzags through. Copter has him in his... Oh, no, Thuganaut tried to take him on. PBay is very quick. Boyd fights his way through and completes his initial pass. PBay picks up more points before calling it off backwards on 1 foot. We are back again with Chispa, number 10. Oh, I see your tweets. Go Thunder! Thank you, Maria.
Lining up against Bobby Smack from Carnage, number 44.
If anyone from Argentina is watching, what time is it over there? Are you guys staying up? PB goes for the outside.
Just bye.
Oh, sorry. they're both actually quite agile.
Just very bar. Similar skating styles from just those two jammers.
Me. Yes, I'm sorry. Bobby Smack makes it through on his initial. Chispa zigzagging through. He looks up. He calls it. He has got to have one of the most calmest jammer faces I have ever seen.
Very focused, very determined.
Very focused. Yes, we have yellow 1-2 Cruz, who cruises on by on the jam line up against David Deckham.
Seeing a bit more spread out packs in this game from the previous game of Smash versus Vanguard.
Cruz takes lead.
David Deckham
takes a penalty.
Track cut. And will be sitting for 30 seconds in the bin.
We have a power jam to the ThunderQuads.
Cruz making quick work of all of those Carnage players. Getting a bit of help from his blockers to make a quick pass from Cruz for another 5 points on the board for the ThunderQuads.
Terminator with his eyes on David Deckham, who's trying to help out his blockers by giving Cruz a little friendly tap on the hip there. Done it, recycling Deckham. Oh, bit of a pileup there, but it's okay. David Deckham being recycled again by Donut. They're standing up on the line. Meanwhile, Cruz has picked up 5 more points. Terminator recycling Deckham.
This Cruz. One might be finding its natural conclusion if David Deckham stays stuck in that pack.
Oh, there was a sneaky star pass. Thuggernaut took the star and he's completed the initial pass. Thuggernaut is racing around the track. ThunderQuads call the jam.
I believe it was actually a natural conclusion
for that one. Natural conclusion.
It was a 2-minute jam. They've been running these jams pretty long in this game. Seems to be just rack up those points every jam, unlike the Vanguard, who were hitting it and quitting it. 4 points up and call. The Carnage jammers are finding hard work of those ThunderQuads walls. It's Boyd finding his way through the pack and getting called lead jammer. Carnage.
And Raichu is through.
Holding Raichu for Boyd to get some points on the board. He's got them in his pocket and just wants to clear that last one before calling it off. No points on the board for ThunderQuads. And another 4 for Carnage.
On the jam line, we have P-Bay and Bobby Smack.
Bobby finding his way to the penalty box. Power jam for P-Bay. Got lots of those last night in the game against Vanguard. And just his quick lateral movement, killing it through directional lateral changing, making him a very formidable jammer.
And PB is through again with 5 points. So nimble on his skates. Pension Trek trying to face off. PB speeds past. Picking up 5 more points. Bobby Smack has snuck back onto the track. The Carnage blockers are helping him out. But they're ready for PB again. Someone has a penalty. 9-9 and from ThunderQuads. Pension Trek and 2-0 from Carnage in the penalty box. Meanwhile, P-Base just picked up more points.
Bobby's and still stuck. Finally getting himself through and on off of his initial pass, onto his scoring pass with 35 seconds left in this jam.
P-Base grabs that. He only has to get past one blocker to get all the points. He grabs that point and calls it in perfect timing.
Copter probably going to be the lone blocker for Carnage. Two blockers standing and one blocker sitting for Carnage in the penalty box. David Deckham up against Crew Chispa. Chispa making quick work of that inside line, getting lead jammer. David Deckham not far behind him, though. And starting that race around the track.
Zero, zero. We have Cruz back on the jam line for the ThunderQuads. Up against Boyd from Carnage. Have a team timeout from Carnage. We'd like to take this opportunity to thank our sponsors, Skate Projects and Better Bearings.
Big thank you to all of our officials on and off skates this weekend. Without you, tournaments like this could not run. And we could not play roller derby.
Seconds has been called.
Boyd and Cruz finding those walls.
Cruz takes lead.
But Cruz just sneaks past on that inside line. Boyd getting recycled by the ThunderQuads blockers.
Cruz picks up 5 more points.
Getting a little bit of help from his pivot.
Oh, wow. Yellow 1-7. That was amazing. Mr. Borderline, the way that he towed that line to recycle Boyd. Did you see that pirouette?
The artisticness of the ThunderQuads is what has really impressed me today and makes me want to start taking roller fit classes. The spins and jumps and hops that are happening on this track right now are just amazing.
I feel like the ThunderQuads, they don't mess around. They play a really, really tough game, but they also individually all very beautiful skaters. They
very
have wonderful
beautiful
lines, excellent jumps, good explosion, and like phenomenal control. It is no wonder that these guys are number 13 in the world for men's roller derby. I reckon they could make top 10.
Easily. This weekend, with all of the sanctioned games
work
that are happening, will definitely probably help that the goal and bring them closer to being the top 10 in the world.
We have Raichu on the jam line for the ThunderQuads. And Bobby Smack for Capital Carnage. Lots of high fives between the teams. Lots of thumbs up. A little bit of laughter.
Big thank you to Sydney City Smash for putting on this event and inviting our wonderful guests from Buenos Aires, Argentina, to play and help out MRDA Down Under.
And we have a timeout.
Little bit of track repair happening. It's happens when we don't have dedicated venues.
Oh, we've got the penalty board. JDAM has 3 penalties. Thuganaut has 2. Everyone else has 1 except for Erectile Destruction. And they're off. Copter pushing Raichu back a little bit. Oh. A little crashing into the refs. Thuganaut recycling Raichu. Raichu skipping around. Bobby Smack dealing with a little bit of a pile up there in the front. Bobby Smack gets through and takes the lead.
Raichu just keeps finding those butts of the Carnage blockers. Tries to spin around them, but can't seem to get that little bit of speed he needs. Now he's out.
Raichu gets through past Copter, who is incredible blocker, very difficult to get past. Copter's a wizard, right? And on the jam line, we have one of our best jammers in the world, Yellow 08 P-Bay, up against David Deckham. Oh, they had the penalties. Okay.
We missed it. Very distracted by the roller derby that's happening on the track.
And they're off. David Deckham to the inside line and P-Bay holding him off. Terminator back from the box, helping out P-Bay get through.
Jamie Slanister just doing a great job of a one-on-one blocking P-Bay, but nothing can hold him back.
P-Bay has lead. David Deckham being held up by number 99. Donette. Nope. Yeah. PBA is through again, getting 5 points.
David Deckham finding his way to the penalty box.
For a cut track. It's a power jam to the ThunderQuads.
Leo Slayer being sent to the bin. He's an NSO. He should know better.
P-Bay juking past pension check. He has the fastest feet in the room. P-Bay slicing through again. He is on a 25-point jam. He has 30 seconds to make it a 30-point jam. Come on. Here we go.
Easily done.
Absolutely beautiful skating from P-Bay. Leo Slayer is back on the track. David Deckham is also back on the track, but what is going on? David Deckham's being sent back to the penalty box, which means it is another power jam for P-Bay.
ThunderQuads will start the next jam with the advantage.
Power jam start to the ThunderQuads. Lining up, we have Chispa. Oh, wait a minute. It's a timeout.
Timeouts are a great time to thank our sponsors, Better Bearings and...
Skate Project. If you want booty shorts, numbers on your shirt or jackets, if you want ref stripes, go see Skate Project.
Axiom letting us know that that timeout is being called to make sure that all of the paperwork is correct and the jam score is correct. That was a big jam in that last one. They just, officials need to make sure that they've got everything under control and that the score is a current reflection of what has actually happened on the track. 4 points going up on the board for Carnage in that last one. Versus the 34 from the ThunderQuads. It's been an excellent start to the Derby here at Sydney Boys High School. If you are just tuning in, I am Lioness, joined by Sasha Fierce, who is currently enjoying a sausage sizzle. Those of you who are on your way to the venue, don't forget to stop and enjoy your sausage sizzle on your way in. The lovely boys from City City Smash have made sure that we are well taken care of today. Power jam start for Chispa. Hopefully getting a little bit of help from his blockers, holding back the Carnage. Yep, and they're through.
Chispa takes lead. We got the ThunderQuads pack up the back, holding back Copter.
Copter wearing the pivot stripe, waiting for his buddy David Deckham to be released from the power jam box.
Chispa is through again. David Deckham is being recycled by Terminator.
Those just quick little knocks from the ThunderQuads are causing all of those jammers with a bit of speed to get hit out of the track and have to recycle back. Costing them a lot of time and energy. But David Deckham is finally through. We'll see if Chispa gives him the opportunity to put some points on the board. And no, he calls it off.
Good point protection. On the track we have Sosa, Terminator. On the jam line, we have Chispa. We have KQ blocking the pivot stripe. And number 99, done it. Oh, boy, it just smashes into the wall, but the ThunderQuads take lead. Oh, it's Cruz. Oh, unpleasant. That noise.
Turning my mic on would help, wouldn't it?
Cruz calls the jam.
Beautiful hit from Boyd in that last jam. Just cleaning up the other one of the blockers there. You can see it. Oh, we felt it here at Sydney Boys High.
Yeah, we felt that in the floor. Like the floor vibrated when he hit the deck. All right, we have 2-8 jamming for the ThunderQuads. That's Raichu and 44 Bobby Smack. Raichu just makes it through on the outside line, no problem. Super quick off the line like that. He takes lead.
Copter trying to give Bobby a bit of a help with the assist there. Bobby, oh, maintaining. One-footed on the outside line to stay in.
Morsa holding up Bobby with number four, Bergaglio. Oh, it's 4 on 44. Bobby got through, but he's through. Bobby Smack has completed his initial pass against the ThunderQuads.
Power jam
situation as Raichu was sent to the penalty box.
Copter getting in there, trying to pick off a bunny for Bobby to get some points on the board for the Carnage. And he's through all 5 points. Raichu making his way back onto the track, but Bobby's got the advantage now.
Bobby going up against Morsa, Terminator, and Mr. Borderline as Raichu sneaks through with his quick feet.
No pass, no penalty on that one. He's only going to score 3 points. This jam.
Wow. That was a great big hit from number 4. Bergayo holding up Bobby Smack.
3 walls. Just absolutely amazing. The control and strength from these players.
Mr. Borderline making Copter fall out on that outside apex line. Lots of high fives between the teams. With more than 100 points ahead, the ThunderQuads are maintaining their winning streak for this tournament.
Timeout from the ThunderQuads, just pulling it back in. Everybody was getting a little bit messy in that last one. I think just everybody needs to have a
Oh, guys, I don't speak Spanish.
Oh, neither do I. Anybody, any Spanish speakers out there want to give us a translation? We'll be happy.
But keep the tweets coming, because when the ThunderQuads look back on this footage, they will see your support on the screen there.
Maybe get our Spanish-speaking friends to translate for us post-game. But we'll let them continue to focus on what's happening on the track right now.
The end of the team timeout is called. We have P-Bay setting up next to David Deckham.
Pack advantage for the ThunderQuads with 1-1-0-1. No, cliffhanger for Carnage in the bin.
P-Bay makes it through on the inside line in no time. David Deckham, he makes it through, but he is sent to the penalty box for a track cut. It is a power jam to the Thunder Quads. Oh, I think that one said, I love the Thunder Quads, or something like that. I saw the word Amor in there and Thunder.
Probably a...
Thank you for sending your tweets in.
Correct assumption with our limited Spanish knowledge.
And Pepe is through again. Keep those tweets coming with your support for the Thunder Quads. And of course, if you're watching from Canberra, show some support for Capital Carnage. P-Bay's through again. 5 more points.
Just ducks down and finds his way under the arms of all of those skaters. David Deckham on the outside.
David Deckham finishes his initial pass. P-Bay sees it, and he turns around and calls it. So stylish. We have Chispa on the jam line, Mr. Borderline. Number 4, Bergayo. We have Terminator lining up for the ThunderQuads. For Carnage, we have Copter, Enigma. We have Boyd, and someone whose number I can't see.
think that is
pension check.
Yeah.
The Azulbub is in the penalty box for Carnage.
Boyd being recycled back by Mr. Borderline.
Just zigzagging through and out on the apex. Wait a minute. Yeah, he gets lead. Boyd completes his initial pass. Chispa calls it off. Chispa takes how many? So 4 points for that jam. Boyd on zero. The score right now is Carnage 28, ThunderQuads 205. I think with a score difference this big, I think we can just start to watch and enjoy the beautiful skating from both teams, as Carnage is challenged by one of the best men's teams out there. And we just see some beautiful like individual skate skills and displays of fitness from the ThunderQuads.
This is actually the first games for Carnage as an MRDA sanctioned team now.
Wasn't that yesterday?
Completed their sanctioning earlier this week. So these are the first several games for them to get their ranking.
Beautiful skating from David Deckham as he completes his initial pass. Chispa gets points and Cruz gets points and calls it.
Probably have time for one or two more jams in this this first period here.
Raichu on the jam line for the ThunderQuads. He's up here against Bobby Smack from Capital Carnage. We have KQ, we have Terminator, and we have... Oh, they covered his number just as I went to look. Is that Mr. Borderline?
I believe that is...
We have J-Dam, we have Copter, we have Thuggernaut, and is that Enigma?
1-7, yeah, Mr. Borderline for the ThunderQuads. Jam is on, a little bit of jammer-on-jammer action before they hit the pack.
Nice strategy with the blockers pushing back beyond the jam line. Bobby Smack taking front pack with a little help from Copter. It is a power jam to Carnage as number 2-8. Raichu gets sent to the penalty box.
Bobby getting some help from his blockers to help get him push that lines to the front. Trying to get that out of play penalty called. And lead jammer status for Bobby Smack. Let's see him put some points on the board for Carnage. Bobby getting his hips around, but just not quite enough speed to wrap himself completely around those ThunderQuads. They have an amazing center of gravity. Bobby putting 5 points on the board for Carnage, but
Raichu
is just right there. Enigma going out and down means Raichu can get back on the track immediately without having to be recycled back because there
is
no one in front.
The pack is speeding up. They are running away.
Definitely a bit more spread out pack in this game than our first game this morning.
Bobby Smack calls it off.
With another 3 points on the board for Carnage. Putting them up to 8. And that is the end of our first period here on Down Under Derby TV for MRDA Down Under.
We would like to thank Skate Project and Better Bearings. We will see you guys in 14 minutes.
Vamos,
Thunder.
That means go.
Vamos, Cruz. We'll pass that on. We'll see you guys in 14 and a half minutes. I've been Sasha Fierce.
And I am Lioness.
Thank you so much for tuning in. See you later.
Hey there. You're watching Down Under Derby TV.
Down Under Derby TV.
Hi, I'm Judge Booty. We are the VR, the Virgin Regime. We are a worldwide collective of queer skaters, their allies and their supporters. Roller derby is an inclusive sport. No matter how you identify or who you love, there is a team near you who will welcome you with loving arms and massive bruises.
You're now watching Down Under Derby TV.
And we're back for the second half of Carnage versus the ThunderQuads. The score is Carnage on 36. Some very impressive skating from the skaters in pink. And in yellow, we have the ThunderQuads. They're on 205. First up on the jam line, they have Chispa competing against Boyd.
Full contingent of blockers from both teams on the track right now. And Boyd finding his way through the ThunderQuads for lead jammer.
Copter jumping in front.
Chispa getting held up at the back there, giving Boyd the opportunity to score 5 points.
Oh, Copter comes out. Oh, he stacks it, and Chispa comes on through, completing his initial pass. Boyd calls it to protect the points.
Getting 3 on that pass for a total of 8 in that first jam of this second half.
Yeah,
first.
We have David Deckham up against Cruz. One of my favorite things about Cruz is that when he gets out and he gets lead, he does a little fist pump and he goes, yeah.
I like it when skaters congratulate themselves.
Skaters should congratulate themselves all the time. I love it.
David Deckham taking a bit of a run-up to hit that pack of ThunderQuads.
And it works. Oh, wait. David Deckham's out in front, but the ThunderQuads have lead. A little jammer-on-jammer action on the apex. Cruz running up the inside line. These are two speedy skaters. Oh, no. Cruz falls over. He calls it off.
Trying to get a low block called on David Deckham, but...
The ref says no.
Refs are having a quick chat about that in the middle.
Oh, they're talking about it?
Yeah, I can see the two jammer refs having a little discussion. But no penalty.
All right, for the ThunderQuads, we have Raichu up against Bobby Smack for Carnage. We have Copter in the pack, Leo Slayer, and Beazelbub, and Cliffhanger.
BP was in the way of us having a little sneaky peek at that. Raichu getting caught up in that beautiful three wall of Carnage.
Oh, we have number 4, Bergayo, making trouble for Bobby Smack again. He's being recycled by Mr. Borderline and being supported by KQ.
Raichu was out with Lee Jammer while Bobby's still fighting through those last couple ThunderQuads.
And that's 5 more points for Raichu for the ThunderQuads.
All I can think is Thundercats when we say ThunderQuads, and it makes me really happy. So I'm just a big cat.
Raichu dealing with Copter. Oh, inside line. He's through on the inside line. Cliffhanger coming around to challenge. Leo Slayer trying to join him there. Raichu is through. Oh. Forearms called on Bobby Smack, so it is a power jam to the ThunderQuads. Raichu has the... Oh, wow. Raichu being hit out by Copter there, but Mr. Borderline is holding Copter from recycling Raichu too far back.
Nice little apex jump on the inside from Raichu, getting those next 5 points on the board for the ThunderQuads.
Oh, Copter laying a perfect hit on Raichu. We have 2 international level skaters here. I believe they're both World Cup champions. Copter taking Raichu one-on-one. Bobby Smack is back on the track.
I think he's trying to pass the panty off to Copter, but Copter was not seeing that sneaky little behind pass.
We have Boyd on the jammer line for Capital College and PB for the Thunder Quads. Have you been able to spot our official? Oh, hi, Light City.
Hi, Light City.
Oh, yes, thank you for sending officials to us. Light City hosted the men's nationals in November last year in Adelaide, and they're helping us out by sending officials. Thank you.
Little bit of a lead up for those jammers on that one. Pibe following Boyd through, and Pibe getting his way out of that pack real quick. Boyd not far behind, though. I'm really sorry about my mic, guys. I'm trying to find the right balance here. Pibe just zipping through the outside. Thugger not talking about how good he is on the track.
He's like, yeah, that was good.
He's like, really good.
Thuggernaut just having a little banter with us, praising Pibe. Thank you, Argentina, for sending Pibe here. They're having a great time playing against you guys. All right, we have Chispa up against David Deckham.
Pack advantage for the ThunderQuads on this one. We've got one Carnage player in the bin right now. David Deckham staying up beautifully on those hits.
Chispa ducking in and around through those pink blockers. David Deckham takes lead. Chispa is hot on his heels. David Deckham is determined to put points on the board.
ThunderQuads
speed up the track.
Finding his way to the bin again, keeping that advantage for the pack, for the ThunderQuads. David Deckham getting some points on the board, but not before Chispa gets two on him.
Here's a replay. Nice call off in that replay.
Big thank you to everyone from Down Under Derby TV for coming out this weekend and helping us get all of the action out to you guys at home. If you are at home and in the Sydney area, come on down. Have a gander at everybody playing in this lovely auditorium today. And get yourself a sausage sizzle in and around your mouth. Cruz and Bobby Smack wearing the stars for the teams playing right now, Capital Carnage and ThunderQuads. Cruz out for lead jammer. Bobby Smack getting recycled, taking the star off his head, trying to find his pivot.
Cruz is cruising through again, another 5 points. Pension Check is running back onto the track to regain the pack. Pension Check would like to shout out to Beers and Juicio in Perth. Hi, guys, from Pension Check. Thuggernaut had the star. I think Thuggernaut's quickly becoming one of my favorite skaters on the track. He is nothing but praise for the opposing team, and he's giving it his all. He's saying, I'm not a jammer. Why'd you give me the star?
Thuggernaut, I totally understand. Last year as a pivot, I constantly got given the star and realized that I probably shouldn't pivot.
We have Raichu on the line for the Thunder Quads. Boyd has hit the front of the pack up against a sea of yellow. Oh, Raichu zipping around. Boyd is knocked out. Mr. Borderline is recycling him back to the jam line. Thunder Quads quickly reset. Oh, big hit on Sospa, who is right back up and repaying the favor. Oh, he gets lead. Does he get lead? He got lead. The ThunderQuads have a big lead, but he got a big hit on him. Boyd is through, but Boyd does not have lead. The ThunderQuads calls the jam. We have Enigma dancing onto the track. Here's a live action replay. Oh, big hits there. On the jam line, we have David Deckham up against Pibe from the Thunder Quads. Hebe is already through. Wow. Hebe taking advantage of that wide pack and just zigzagging through, picking up five more points. David Deckham being recycled by Terminator and Donut. Oh, he falls over backwards into a very interesting position. This is why we stretch. Nice work, David Deckham. Morzo recycling David. Pibe coming around for another scoring trip. David Deckham sneaking through on the inside line. Oh, David Deckham gets a cut track. Pibe gets 5 points. And it's a power jam to the Thunder Quads. Pibe just zigzagging through, forcing Cliffhanger to just fall over on himself. Pibe using some fancy footwork to keep his stability. Big smile on his face as he approaches the pack. He's through again, another 5 points. So far on a 25-point jam.
30 seconds left to go. Most jammers can probably do a lap in about 10 or 11 seconds. We could see another two scoring passes on for Pibe, depending on how quickly he can make work of that Carnage pack.
It.
And done. Easy.
You got 16 seconds. He's slowed down a little. Oh, big falling. Some penalties being awarded there. Pibe come through on another scoring pass. He's still in. Nice work. I wonder if this has been his highest scoring jam for the tournament. That's 34. No, he got 34 points in a jam previously. So.
Yeah.
I'm going to hang out to see if he can beat that. Here we have a slow motion replay of Pibe just zigzagging through, making short work of Cliffhanger.
That one-footed glides along the outside line through the apex are just like absolutely phenomenal. It makes me want to definitely work on my one-footed
we have Bobby
roller derby.
On the jam line for Carnage up against Chispa.
And a team timeout being called for by Carnage. Good use of the team timeout. About 18 minutes left in this second half, and they've got another timeout after this one. Strategic use of timeouts gives everybody a little bit of a break, some chance to have a bit of strategy chat. More so than what they had in the change room at halftime. Also gives us commentators a little bit of time to have a little dance break and some water.
We got the penalty board up here on four. We have number 2 KQ and 800 Terminator on three penalties, Sosa and Donette. On two penalties, we have Raichu, Bergayo, Morsa. On one penalty, Cruz and Mr. Borderline. Pibe, Chispa, both jammers, penalty free. Pablitox and Santa, also penalty free. Clean slates for those four skaters. Nice work. Chispa and Bobby Smack are fielded once again, getting ready for the end of that timeout. We have J-Dam, Thuganaut, and number 1-5, Jammy Slamister, blocking for Carnage. We have Terminator and, Bergayo blocking. Mr. Borderline. And one more, number 44.
Pablitox
blocking for the ThunderQuads, and the ThunderQuads take lead. Beautiful apex jump from Chispa. He picks up 5 points for the Thunder Quads. Beautiful skating.
Bobby pushing that pack to its limit, trying to get that 20-foot engagement zone.
Pablitox not giving up. Pablitox is joined by his team, Terminator.
And Mr. Borderline.
Bobby Smack versus Terminator, but you can't get past those guys. Nobody can. Bobby Smack might.
Jammy coming in to try and get him a bit of assistance. Bobby taking off the star, hoping to find his pivot, but his pivot is doing an excellent job of holding Chispa at the back of the pack.
Chispa takes another 5 points. Bobby Smack has stashed the star, and Cliffhanger is hanging out at the front. Jammy Slamister facing off against Chispa, being held up by J-Dam. But Chispa's footwork is so good, and Cliffhanger has taken the star. He's chasing down Chispa, and they've sped up the pack. The ThunderQuads have their pivot in the penalty box. Oh, Thuganort lays a big hit on Chispa just as he jumps. And Chispa got the penalty?
Chispa's getting a low block penalty.
Wait, no, he's going back to the bench.
Thuganort
is standing near the bench. All right, so we have Enigma on the track for Carnage, and that's it. Because Carnage have 3 blockers in the penalty box, they've got Boyd on the jam line up against KQ, who hasn't jammed yet this game. I can't wait to see it. All right, Copter is the only one blocking KQ. Thuganort has rejoined. He's been returned to track. He has to wait to serve his time because the box is full. Boyd trying to deal with Donut. Donut recycles him.
Copter hitting Cruz to the outside and making him recycle back.
And Cruz gets through.
Thuganort now sitting down as Jammy and J-Dam coming back from the box to help out Copter.
And Cruz picks up another 5 points as he cruises on through.
Boyd has stashed the star and is trying to find Copter at the front.
We got 3 people holding off Copter to allow KQ to pass. Oh, number yellow 44 sent to the penalty box. Whoa!
KQ.
Boyd loses his footing. KQ just flies on by. Oh, okay. I think there was a star pass. Copter has the star in his hand. Copter is trying to get past. He's trying to get past Bergoglio, who has recycled him. Donut.
It's a power jam for Carnage. I don't know if
and he's
Copter
out.
Knows that. Got to get that star on before he can start scoring any points.
Copter completed his initial pass. He's on his first scoring trip.
KQ standing in the box, ready to hit that pack.
Whoa, beautiful apex jump from the Thunder Quads.
Copter trying his best to get that in way of KQ as he was coming around the inside.
Copter takes 4 points. We have the penalties. David Deckham, he's on 5 penalties. Better watch out. Let's see. Cliffhanger on 4. Beelzebub on 4. J-Dam on 3. David Deckham is on the line. Cruz is jamming for the ThunderQuads. He's running up that inside line, and he takes lead.
David Deckham is trying to stay on that foot outside and that foot inside before he gets the cut.
David
Gotta
Deckham
keep
being
that foot
caught
down.
By Terminator. Vamos, David Deckham. Vamos, Cruz.
Vamos, everyone.
We learned one word.
we got one Spanish word, guys. Let's get some more tweets coming and teach Sasha and I some more Spanish.
Yeah, teach us how to cheer for your team.
There's a whole lot of hitting the deck on that one. Cruz
cruising through backwards.
David Deckham.
Holding off David Deckham. I love some jammer action.
The forearm penalty.
It's a power jam to the Thunder Quads. Mr. Borderline from the ThunderQuads also being sent to the penalty box. So we've got even packs. We've got 3-3.
Pack advantage to Carnage with all of their blockers on the track.
Sorry.
Power jam for the ThunderQuads.
Right. David Deckham has stashed the star in the box. Oh, that makes sense. That's his sixth penalty. If David Deckham gets one more penalty, he will be expelled from the game. Or he will foul out from the game.
Yes, the footwork of the ThunderQuads is magnificent. Thanks, Joe. Keep tweeting to us, guys. We are trying to keep up with everyone on this beautiful Sunday morning in Sydney from Down Under Derby TV.
Whoa! Oh, that was a really beautiful jump over skater there by Cruz. We have Jammy Salamister taking the star for the first time this game for Capital Carnage from Canberra. Up against him, we have Raichu for the ThunderQuads. We also have a little bit of track repair going on. Thank you to our officials and NSOs. Thank you, Switzerland. That's her name, Switzerland. Sorry, not like the country. I meant the person. And they're off. Jammy Slamister taking the outside line.
Thuggernaut getting the low block on that one. He knew it. He was already kind of mentally taking himself to the bin.
Jammy Slamister takes lead. Raichu gets recycled by Enigma.
Raichu making his initial pass and finding his way through.
Oh, we've got some screams from the Carnage bench saying, call, call, call. Jammy Slamister didn't hear them, so he just ran through and got points instead. Nice work.
Carnage are keeping Raichu from getting any more points. Jamie getting another pass, and I think he should have gotten 5 for that one. I'm pretty sure he is lapped, but the signal from the jam referee is that it's 4 points.
Oh, a cut track penalty is being issued to Jammy Slamister, which means it is a power jab to Raichu.
And this will be a full 2-minute jam. As soon as you go to the box, you are no longer lead jammer.
No lead, no call-off. Raichu picking up points.
Score is 339 for the ThunderQuads, 260 from Carnage. Carnage putting up a really good fight today, skating their hearts out on the track and just giving it everything they've got.
Natural end of jam. Replay. All right, we have Boyd up against Black 08 PB from the ThunderQuads.
Pack that advantage agility for ThunderQuads in this one. PB making easy work. Work of that butt.
Oh, PB is just like jumping over a skater's butt on the apex there. Not even on the line, just, you know, because he can. Oh, beautiful. He does a single foot transition on the outside line and calls it as he watches the pack. And he's like, oh, did I get it in time? Yeah, I did.
Boyd was pretty hot on his trail, though. Trying
to work.
Get some pressure on to the ThunderQuads from Carnage.
We have David Deckham on the line for Capital Carnage up against, oh, hello, Chispa. I love you, Dale. You're a Quiliado. What did they make me say? Oh, and they're off. David Deckham to the outside. Chisper being held back by J-Dam and Recti. Thuganaut bridging. The ThunderQuads hold back David Deckham as Chisper takes lead. David Deckham's pretty hot on his heels though. David Deckham's going to be one to watch out for at Nationals, I reckon.
Yes, definitely.
Chisper calls it.
But he's getting a skating out of bounds penalty. Carnage will be starting this one on a power jam. Always a nice way to start a jam.
And we have KQ on 5 penalties. Oh, better watch out. Bergayo on 4. Terminator on 4. Sosa on 3. Donnet on 3. Bobby Smack taking his power jam, facing off against the Thunderwood Copter in to help ease the pressure a little bit. There's Cliffhanger out the front, helping him get past Morsa. And Bobby Smack takes lead for Capital Carnage. He has lead, and it's a power jam.
Carnage doing their best to catch a bunny and help out Bobby by making those points really easy to score. Speeding up the pack a little bit.
On Morsa.
Just about out of the box. Bobby calling it.
Bobby calling it as Donnet knocked him out and did a apex jump back in the opposite direction to recycle him all the way back to the other side of the apex. A very impressive work from both skaters. We have Boyd on the jam line up against Carruz from the ThunderQuads.
David Deckham sitting on those six penalties. I don't think we'll be seeing him jam for the rest of the game. Maybe Jamie Slanister will be putting his hand up a little bit more. Boyd having a really clean game.
Oh!
One penalty.
Boyd knocking right backwards into Carruz. And yes, it's called as a high block, so it's a power jam to the ThunderQuads, who take full advantage and take lead for Carruz.
May have jinxed Boyd a little bit there when I said he was having a nice clean game and had only had one penalty scored against him so far. Carnage setting up a nice three wall, just getting a little bit blocked up from number 4, Mr. Borderline. Bergallo to get Carruz through for quick and easy
and
5 points.
And with a star dash, Astro Boyd is back on the track, but the ThunderQuads have him in sight. He's getting a little help from his friends to run through.
Thuganaut.
He tries to face off Carruz, and Carruz just glides on around. Oh, a cut track penalty for the ThunderQuads. So it is a power jam to Boyd. This jam will go for the full 2 minutes, and there's 50 seconds left of that 2 minutes.
4 minutes left in the second period, giving Carnage ample time.
Oh, Carnage up 69 points.
Get that score up a little bit further. Another 5 points on the board for Carnage.
Wow, some really impressive returning to the track skating by Mr. Borderline, who beats Boyd to the pack and gets right in front.
Leo Slayer making his way to the penalty box as a blocker. Boyd putting up another 5 points as Carruz makes his way from the penalty box and finds that three wall of Thuganaut J-Dam. And the natural conclusion of that game, of that jam.
We have Carnage on 79 points, ThunderQuads on 364. Will Carnage break the 100? We have a replay.
And we have a score update of 81 points for Carnage.
Oh, 81. I reckon that they have enough time to break the 100.
I think the 3 minutes is more than enough time. David Deckham wearing the star on 6 penalties. Thuganaut now on 5. See how this last couple jams goes.
Raichu knocked out by Copter on the outside line. Wow, a straight line apex jump by Donnet to get back to recycle David Deckham. Wow.
Deckham just stepping out, knowing he's done it, wants to make sure that he doesn't get that that track cut.
We just had some technical difficulties, but that's okay. In that time, Raichu had lead. David Deckham's been caught on the... he's still on initial. And Raichu is through.
All four blockers from each team on the track right now. Raichu, not sure if he's stepped out or not, makes the quick call to try and gain himself back onto the track upright and inbounds. ThunderQuads doing an excellent job of breaking down that three wall from Carnage. They're not getting any opportunity to stop Cruz, or Raichu, sorry, as he just finds that inside line, does a beautiful straight line apex jump as they wind down the clock in this second period. That was David Deckham's seventh penalty. He'll be out.
But there's only one. There's only time for one more jam left in the game. Oh, and they have fielded P-Bay for the Thunder Quads. Here we go. It says on the screen there, David Deckham, he has fouled out. Thuggernaut is at risk of fouling out. See how we go for that final jam. So it's a power jam start for P-Bay. They've put Puppy Smack in the penalty box to sit David Deckham's penalty.
Bobby is out now. Quick one for that remainder of the penalty.
Oh, wow. Beautiful jump and footwork and spinning and twirling from Pibe as he takes lead for the final jam of Carnage versus ThunderQuads.
Thank you, ThunderQuads, again for traveling all the way to Sydney, Australia to help get these men's teams here. Part of their ranking, you have to play other MRDA teams. This will help everyone in creating a bright future for men's roller derby.
PBA is through again. All the Capital Carnage skaters are standing in their bench area, looking onto the track with admiration for their own teammates and for the visitors from Argentina. PBA zigzagging through again. He's like a bullet.
Just like little flick of the head, and then my feet go the other way, and it's,
He has the fastest feet in this room.
It's really beautiful to watch. Jamie Slanister with the head up. There was a sneaky little star pass in that one. That happened as Carnage was going past their own bench, and we missed it.
The unofficial score is Carnage on 81, ThunderQuads on 408. We wait for the whistle till we call it. Yes, there it is. Argentinians, don't mess around. I love them. It's Francesca. Oh, here. The benchy.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
We just got the little final huddles here for the teams. I wonder if you can hear their cheers on our mics. Thunder Quads! And now for Carnage.
Carnage!
They go stump, Carnage! Huh. I love it.
I love the whole.
I love it. Oh, and they're all hugging each other. See, it looks pretty rough on the track, and it's so true, the Argentinians do not mess around. They have far too much respect for Capital Carnage to go easy. Oh, those colors look good together as well.
They'll take a really nice team photo after.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you to Skate Project and Better Bearings for sponsoring. Thank you to the Sydney Smash Brothers for hosting. Thank you to the ThunderQuads for traveling all the way. stay tuned. We have Scartel versus the Sydney Smash Brothers up next. I have been Sasha Fierce.
And I am Lioness. Thank you for tuning in to Down Under Derby TV.
Thank you.
Hey guys, this is Trixie for Down Under Derby TV. We are here for game two of day two of the MRDA Down Under. I am joined by the wonderful Maro of the ThunderQuads, all the way here from Argentina. They've just played their third game for the weekend, I think, and they have done an absolutely phenomenal job. I wanted to congratulate you. And how do you think your skating styles differ from Australian teams?
The style is basically the same, but the size of the players, it's very different. We have like little jammers, and we are not used to play with such heavy players in the walls. So at the first, we have to play all the time with offense, so we, the jammers, can pass and can move along the walls. But basically, we share a common style, and we try like make our own in the offense, principally.
You guys have played three of our most fantastic teams in Australia, and your next game is up against the Vanguard from Victoria. Are you excited? How do you feel about that one?
Yeah, we're very excited. We watched them play. They are awesome. They have great jammers, and their walls are solid. They don't move and have a very good offense. So we see what we can do about it. We try to think about how it's going to be the game, what we are going to do about it. But I think it's going to be an exciting game, and everyone is going to enjoy it. And I hope it's going to be pretty even for both of the teams. Let's see what we can do to entertain all the people here.
You guys have had some pretty penalty-heavy games these past few games. This last one, you ended with 36 penalties altogether. But will you be sort of watching that more with the Vanguard?
Yes, we try to keep the penalties like to the minimum. But there's different styles of when the referees work. Like each referee has a style. We are trying to read how it's the play here, how they read the plays, and how they assist the penalties. So we are working on it, but we are Latinos. We came from South America. We have our blood, and we like to like be heavy hitters sometimes, but we try to be in order and play like a neat game sometimes. So we try to keep the penalties to the minimum this time.
And of course, lastly, is there anyone you want to say hi to at home?
Yeah, to everyone in Argentina. We have a lot of teams. The ThunderQuads is the result of the development of Derby in Argentina. We are not the only ones. There's other teams. So I think this is dedicated to all the Derby community, with the women's teams, the men's teams, the referees, the NSOs, and all the people that helps grow the Derby in Argentina, makes the ThunderQuads and makes this opportunity possible. So we have many teammates that are in Argentina, and they are here too. We play because we train with them. So this is for all people in Argentina who believes in Derby, who efforts every day and train for this. So we are enjoying it, and they at home are enjoying it too. So this is for all of them.
Well, I'm sure they're all very proud of you. I can't wait to see your final game. I hope everyone sticks around for that one. Once again, we finished with 81 to the Capital Carnage, 404 to the ThunderQuads. Stick around for them playing against Vanguard. Up next, though, we do have Sydney Smash Brothers up against the Brisbane Scartel.
Can I say just one thing? I want to give a big shout out to all the people here in Sydney and the people of Australia that has been very friendly with us. I have a wonderful host too. They give us room so we can live here some days during the tournament, and that was great. We have this present from the guys from Canberra. We are so happy. You have been so friendly with us. Thanks. It ain't enough. So I guess thanks plus.
Well, thank you for coming all the way out here. Good luck with your final game, and thank I can't wait to see what you guys achieve next.
Let's see.
All right. This has been Trixie. Stick around for Vanguard. Sorry, not Vanguard. Smash versus the Scartel.